Hello friends, welcome back my video lecture. In this video lecture we are going to see about the AIR Act, okay, which is a prevention and control of the air pollutions, which is from 1981. So we have know what is the objectives of that act. We have to improve the air quality as well as maintaining the ecosystems or atmospheric conditions. So we have to see what is this act. So this act is provided for the prevention and control and abatement of the air pollution. Obviously this act is made for the only and only for the air pollutions, to control the air pollutions or prevention of the air pollutions, for the establishment with the view to carrying out the aforesaid purpose, or board for the conferring on the assigning to such boards power and the function relating thereto and the for the matter connected therewith. So we have know that it's simply objectives for that act. We have to maintain the all these over air atmospheric quality. So whereas decision were taken at the United Nations Conference on the Human Environment held in Stockholm, okay, this is the Stockholm in June 1972, so in which in India participated, the time to take appropriate steps for the preservation of the natural resources of the earth, which among other things include the preservations of the quality of air and the control of the air pollution. So this is also one of the factor, and other than this also important to maintain the all ecosystems, right? So the India has participated to take the appropriate steps for the preservation of these natural resources, and whereas it is the considered necessary to implement the decision aforesaid in so far as they relate to the preservation of the quality of air and the control of the air pollution. So this is decided at 1981, okay, preservation of the quality of the air and control the air pollutions. So be it intact by the parliament in 32nd year of the Republic of India. Next topic we have to see, that is the human wildlife conflicts in Indian context. Conflict is nothing but the disagreement between the two peoples or two people groups, okay, community, society, you can consider. So the growing human population, deforestation, loss of habitat, the decline in their prey species are few major reasons behind it, okay. So the disagreement between the two community, societies, peoples, so like these regions are there: human population, deforestation, loss of habitat, okay. So they are living as per their respective habitations, right? So the natural wildlife territory is overlapped with the human existence. The various forms of humans wildlife conflict occur with the various negative results, okay, because of the different reasons are there between those kind of groups of peoples. So they can fight each other, and from this the various negative results are occur, okay. So like this you can see the population also there, loss of habitat also there, and decline their prey species. So human wildlife conflict in India are the quite common, as many peoples live close to forest, okay. As per the data collected by the Ministry of Environment, the forest and climate change due to human elephant conflict alone, 2361 peoples were killed between 2014 and 15 to 2018 and 2019. So that much peoples was killed there between these four years, okay, 4 to 5 years, because of the forest and climate change, because of forest and climate change. Okay, and the next total of 276 peoples were killed due to the human tiger conflict between the 2014-15 to 2019-20. Okay, so how much 5 to 6 years you will see within this period 276 peoples were killed because of the human tiger conflicts. Okay, human tiger. So apart from the tigers and the elephants, there are the other animals such as snakes, also leopards, bears and wild boars, so that cause many human death. So because of they are animals also very dangerous to the those people are living into the forest or near the forest or in hilly regions, so they was die there between these years. So according to the ministry data, from the 5 years 2014-15 to 2018-19, total of the elephants died due to train accident. Okay, 333 elephants died due to the electrocutions, 71 elephants died due to the poaching, and 29 elephants died due to the poisoning. So like this death rate you can see of animals and some peoples. Okay, between the this 4 years. Okay, 4 or 5 years. Okay, elephants died due to the train accident, that's this much quantity. Okay, and 71 elephants died due to the poachings, and this much from the poisonings. So like this death of elephants you can see between this period. The maximum number of casualties 30 death and 85 injuries, whereby the leopard attacks followed by the snake bites, where 15 people died and 53 in injuries occurred. Elephants attacks cause 11 deaths and 8 injuries, and bear attacks causing 86 injuries. So this much accident by the animals, right? So each year human elephants conflict result in about 500 humans death, while over the 100 elephants die due to the human relatives activities such as poaching for the ivory or meat, poisoning, and electrocution and collision with the trains. So like this reasons are there to die some peoples. Okay, they are living in the forest, the hilly regions.